everyone! Today I'm gonna review The Loneliest Girl in the Universe by Lauren James. I received an ARC of this through Edelweiss, and this already came out in the UK and will come out in the US on July 3rd. The Loneliest Girl in the Universe is a YA science fiction about a girl who is on a spaceship all on her own, and she has the super important mission to bring this spaceship to a new planet that is kind of supposed to be Earth 2. But a lot has happened on the ship, so she is all on her own and she has communication with Earth, but obviously it takes a lot of time for messages to go back and forth. And then she actually finds out that there is another ship on the way to this planet as well, and because that one has much newer technology, it is much faster and will catch up with her in just a year, and then they will travel together to the new planet much faster as well. She starts communicating with that other ship as well and finds that there is a guy on that ship who's also pretty young, and since they are kind of the only people they have, the only people that they can communicate with without having like a huge gap in between, they really start exchanging a lot of emails, and our protagonist Romy slowly starts falling in love with the guy on the other ship. So I honestly don't even know where to begin with this review, because there's really so much to say about this book, even though this only had a little bit over 300 pages. I thought this was a really, really great science fiction book, and you might know I don't really tend to reach for science fiction, and especially not for space kind of stories. But this really intrigued me, because to me it just really sounded like it was just like a contemporary love story but set in space. So I was super intrigued, and I had heard so many great things about it, like so many of my friends who had read this absolutely loved it. So I could not wait to pick this up, and I'm so happy to say that I just really, really loved this. I thought this book had so many surprises packed into it. I really, as I said, expected this to just be a love story, but it was so interesting to find out much more about this mission of going to this other Earth and about the main character Romy and what she's kind of been through. There's really so much more to this story that you cannot even guess from reading the synopsis. It's so interesting, and it's definitely much more science fiction heavy than you would think, but I thought it was an incredibly interesting kind of science fiction. I thought it was so interesting and so intriguing to follow Romy across this ship and to kind of see her everyday life and to find out about her past and the communication between her and the other ship. I was just like having a really enjoyable experience while reading this, but it also just kept me thinking about so many things. So yeah, really think the concept and the world building, if you can call it that, was really, really fascinating and super well done. Romy is also a really fantastic character. I think she is a wonderful protagonist, and she is so relatable, even though obviously it's an experience that none of us have, it's still so relatable. And she deals so much with mental health issues. She has anxiety, like she even has a therapist on Earth that's like emailing her, making sure that she's okay. But like there's a lot about mental health, and I thought that that was really interesting. I thought Lauren James did this really good balance between having a story of someone who is like totally different from you. You cannot relate to this experience at all. So it's really interesting in that part, but she still leaves so many things that make you feel with her, that make her feel relatable, that make you feel close to her. And I thought that was a great balance, and honestly a thing that I don't think is very easy to do in these kinds of novels, but I think Lauren James really did it so, so well. If you have watched a couple of my reviews, you might know that I find it super important that we have like a good portrayal of sex in YA, and what I want to point out about this one is that I really loved that this mentioned masturbation. Obviously, it's never like anything explicit, we're still in YA, but I just think that it's great when a YA novel actually mentions that masturbation, something that some teens do. Especially in this case, I just feel like it felt very natural the way that it happened, but it just also portrayed it as something that's like normal, like something that if you do it, you don't have to be ashamed of it. I just really, really like that and wanted to point that out, because it's been really important to me to point these kinds of positive portrayals out. I do want to say that this is definitely not an easy read. It is a fast-paced read, it is so bingeable. You can really read this in one sitting, but it is not easy. There's so many really tough topics in this. This is definitely very much like a science fiction thriller in a lot of ways. And there are a couple of scenes that are really, really scary, especially if you're someone who really kind of finds space a little bit scary and just the whole nothingness a little bit scary. I definitely think, like, just be warned going into this because it is very intense, and a lot of the things that Romy goes through, even though she's so used to space and she's so used to being alone, she still goes through some phases where she just cannot handle it anymore and she has really bad nightmares, and there's just a lot going on in this. So as I said, expect a YA science fiction thriller more than anything, because yeah, there is a romantic storyline in here, but it really is just a small part compared to Romy's everyday life on the ship, and that can be really, really scary. And I just really want to mention that, like, I genuinely, and I'm not someone who gets easily scared while reading, but I genuinely had some moments that really, really creeped me out. So I just want to put that out there so you kind of know what to expect. I think this is a wonderful book. I think this will catch you off guard so many times. It's great. I'd highly recommend it. And yeah, these are all my thoughts on The Loneliest Girl in the Universe. Let me know if you've already read the book. Especially my UK viewers might have already read this, so I want to know what you thought about it. And if you're still waiting for the release, I want to know if you're excited about it. Are you planning on picking it up? And thank you so much for watching. I guess I'll see you soon. Bye!